Hello, and welcome to the session on the meaning and scope of education technology. The word technology is from a Greek word techne, which means craft or art. The term technology refers to the application of science to art. UNESCO, the United Nations Education, Social and Cultural Organization, define technology as the know-how and creative processes that may assist people to utilize tools, resources, and systems to solve problems and to enhance control over the natural and made environment in an endeavor to improve the human condition, UNESCO 1985. Thus, technology involves the purposeful application of knowledge, experience, and resources to create processes and products that meet human needs. When we apply science of learning and communication to teaching, we evolve a technology. Technology can refer to material objects of use to humanity, such as machines or hardware. It can also encompass broader themes, including systems, methods of organization, and techniques. Some modern tools include overhead projectors, laptop computers, and calculators. Still, newer ones include smartphones and games, including both online and offline. Today's world is one that world of information that uses mass media in creating an atmosphere of awareness among masses. Media here means different communicated channels through which information is transmitted to the receiver. Education technology is the use of technology in education to improve learning and teaching. Since education technology is often associated with and encompasses instructional theory and learning theory, it is also called instructional technology or learning technology. The term education technology was recognized in the year 1967 with the establishment of the National Council for Education Technology in the United Kingdom. The United Kingdom Association for Programmed Learning promptly added educational technology to its title in 1968. Educational technology is the study and ethical practice of facilitating learning and improving performance by creating, using, and managing appropriate technological processes and resources. According to the definition given by the Association for Educational Communications and Technology, ACT, Definitions and Terminology Committee, education technology includes other systems used in the process of developing human capability. Educational technology includes, but is not limited to, software, hardware, as well as internet applications and activities. Every technology has its own advantages and limitations. Thus, education technology is seen by many people in different ways. Advocates of education technology claim that the use of modern machines to reach distant educational markets is revolutionizing education. Technology-based instruction produces measurable and significant changes in the learners. It helps the teacher in the following areas: preparing timetables and schedules, allocating learning materials as per individual needs, providing information for guidance and references, providing immediate feedback to the learners, providing direct interaction with the learners, evaluating learners in a more effective way, classifying learners according to their achievements, engaging them in tutorial works, facilitating them with bibliographic searches. Those people who are against the use of technology in education express the fact that electronic machines is a treat to the type of teaching where there was much more interaction between the teacher and the student. According to them, the instructor or the teacher will have to play a pivotal role for the success of learning, and there cannot be any substitute for him. Education technology could be defined in simple terms as the efficient organization of any learning system, adapting or adopting methods, processes, and products to serve identified educational goals. This would involve systematic identification of the goals of education, taking into account nationwide needs, the system capabilities, and the learner's needs and potential. Recognition of needs means not to fulfill their immediate needs, but also future needs. Designing and enabling proper teaching learning systems that could realize these goals should also be taken into consideration. Other things necessary is to develop a range of support systems and training. Reaching these to the school system and training teachers and students to use them. Appreciation of the role of education technology as an agent of change in the classroom, influencing the teacher and the teaching learning process and its role in systemic issues like reach, equity, and quality is the most important. Objectives of education technology. There are many objectives of education technology. The first being to modernize the learning methods and techniques after systematizing them so that these may be turned effective according to the needs of the changing era and for the unknown future. The second objective of educational technology is the desirable modifications in the behaviors of the teachers and pupils by improving the teaching, learning, and evaluation conditions. The third objective of educational technology is to make the classroom's teaching easy, clear, interesting, effective, understandable, objective, and scientific. Education technology also helps in increasing various facilities by solving the most complicated problems of human life so that the human life may carry on its progress continuously. Other objectives of education technology are transmitting information, assisting the practice of specific skills, contribution to the provision of feedback, the need to reach out to maximum number of students, to offer greater opportunities for independent study, to design, modify, and develop appropriate equipment, aids suitable and relevant to the educational process, to identify the educational needs of the learner, to identify the necessary teaching learning materials, to plan teaching strategies, models, and methods as per the need and objectives, to evaluate the effectiveness of teaching strategy in terms of learning outcomes, to provide appropriate feedback to student as well as teachers, to modify the teaching learning process on the basis of feedback received. Technology is helping teachers to expand beyond linear text-based learning and to engage students who learn best in other ways. Its role in schools has evolved from a contained computer class into a versatile learning tool that could change how we demonstrate concepts, assign projects, and assess progress. Effective technology programs encourage students to be productive, innovative, and enterprising. This involves generating ideas and taking action, as well as developing techniques and products that satisfy human needs. Different aspects of education technology. Education technology has three major aspects. Input. Input involves the entering behavior of the learner, the previous achievement and abilities of the student, and level of motivation. It also involves the skill of teaching and awareness of teaching and training methods. Process. Process involves the means and devices of learning experiences. It involves selection and use of appropriate teaching strategies and tactics for desired learning structure. Output. output includes the terminal behavior of the learner. Components of education technology. There are different components of education technology: behavior technology, instruction technology, teaching technology. Behavior technology emphasizes the use of psychological principles in learning and teaching. Behavior technology intends to expand, progress, and develop in the field of behavior and learning. In the instruction technology, the presentation of the contents is described in or out of the class. It includes teaching materials prepared on the basis of machines like tape recorder, record player, television, projector, etc. According to S.M. McMurrin, instruction technology is a systematic way of designing, carrying out and evaluating the total process of learning and teaching in terms of specific objectives based on research, on human learning and communication, and employing a combination of human and non-human resources to bring out more effective instruction. Teaching technology makes teaching more effective, easy, precise, and objective by using scientific principles. Teaching technology includes both content and communication. Thus, it includes both behavior and instruction technology. Benefits of education technology. Education technology is the efficient organization of any learning system adapting or adopting methods, processes, and products to serve identified educational goals. This involves systematic identification of the goals of education, recognition of the diversity of learners' needs, the context in which learning will take place, and the range of provisions needed for each of these. The challenge is to design appropriate systems that will provide for and enable appropriate teaching learning systems that could realize the identified goals. The key to meeting this challenge is an appreciation of the role of education technology as an agent of change in the classroom, which includes not only the teacher and the teaching learning processes, but also systemic issues like reach, equity, and quality. Using technology for education has many benefits. Easy to access course materials is one of the most important benefits of education technology. Students can study the materials for their course at any time, any location they prefer if the instructor posts the course material. Learning materials are available for a wider audience. Learning materials can be used for long-distance learning. Students get easily motivated since computers are non-judgmental. There is much education software available that help the students and the teachers alike in a different ways. The students can actually find out the practical application of the theory that they are learning in the classrooms. Since teaching is done through latest technology, there would be wide participation from the student side. The students can be given the assignments in the form of PowerPoint presentations. By this, the curriculum is made interesting, and also the active participation of the students contributes a lot in the development of their personality. The students, through the internet and the intranet, stay connected and participate in the discussions. With proper structuring of the technologies used, it can become easier to monitor and maintain student work while also quickly gauging modifications to the instruction necessary to enhance student learning. It is convenient for students to edit their written work on word processors, which can in turn improve the quality of their writing. Subjects are made easier to learn. Differentiated instruction instigates interest in them. Educational technology provides the means to focus on active student participation and to present differentiated questioning strategies. It broadens individualized instruction and promotes the development of personalized learning plans. Instant feedback can be given to the students since it is a computer-based instruction. There is software which can record and check the performance of the students, on the basis of which the students can be suggested different ways to improve their performances. New technology can be an appropriate vehicle for promoting meaningful and engaged learning. It allows students to work on authentic, meaningful, and challenging problems, similar to tasks performed by professionals in various disciplines, to interact with the data in ways that allow student-directed learning, to build knowledge collaboratively, and to interact with professionals in the field. Technologies also can be used to promote the development of higher order thinking skills and allow opportunities for teachers to act as facilitators or guides and often as a co-learner with the students. Scope of education technology. Scope of education technology depends upon the context in which it is used. If education technology is used as the audiovisual aids, mechanical and electrical gadgets, the scope is very limited to prove the educational messages. If the same term is used as a process-oriented technique, then its scope is limited to production of teaching learning material. The different scopes of education technology are the following. Spelling out educational goals and objectives. Education technology helps for the formulation of objectives and goals of education based on individualized and social needs. Developing strategies. It helps in teaching strategies and devising approaches. The methods are developed catering to different types of students and their requirement. Curriculum development. The planning of curricular and co-curricular inputs is done in order to realize planned goals and objectives. To reduce the burden of teachers, education technology supports the teacher in teaching learning process. Developing teaching learning materials and resources. Education technology develops necessary learning materials in the form of programmed learning books, computer learning packages, mass media instruction, individualized self-instructional packages, etc. Develops learning environments. Education technology develops learning environment that are learner-friendly. Developing human resources. Education technology covers the area of teacher education. Developing multisensory aids. Design and development of audiovisual aids also takes place. Develops interactive instruction services. Education technology tries to provide opportunities for the learner to control the pace and mode of presentation. Develops passive instruction services. Latest technologies like educational radio, TV, and computers are used for transmitting information. They are passive services since all decisions are in the hands of the providers. The provider of these services decides what to be presented, for how long it should be presented, in what sequence and when. Develops communication devices. Education technology has developed communication devices for students who have mental capability to communicate but are not able to speak. Developing information resources. Education technology helps in bridging the gap between developments in information technology and education. Information resources. There are various resources available for the learners, like e-libraries, online encyclopedia, World Wide Web, etc. Feedback mechanism and modification. Education technology develops tool of evaluation to provide feedback. The scope of education technology is its use in three areas: instructional process, general educational administration and management, education testing, scope of educational technology in instructional process, selection of teaching learning methodologies as per the needs of the learners, selection of appropriate audiovisual aids as per the nature of the content, helps the teachers to define the specific educational objectives in behavior terms, enables the teacher to measure the learning outcomes in a proper way, teaching models, language laboratory, micro teaching, simulated teaching, team teaching, programmed learning materials, teaching skills, teaching methodologies, etc., are the contribution of educational technology. Scope of educational technology in educational administration and management. Training of the teachers at a mass level. Widening access of education. Online registration for the courses. Online admission processes. Use of CCTVs in the classrooms. This helps in easy monitoring of the class through a CCTV control room. Radio broadcasting, television telecasting, online computer education, etc., is the byproduct of educational technology. Scope of educational technology in educational testing. Designing and developing of various tools of testing. New assessment criteria and procedures are byproduct of educational technology. The system approach of educational technology helps in providing proper feedback. Let us summarize the major ideas in this session. The word technology is from a Greek word techne, which means craft or art. UNESCO, the United Nations Education, Social and Cultural Organization, defines technology as the know-how and creative processes that may assist people to utilize tools, resources, and systems to solve problems and to enhance control over the natural and made environment in an endeavor to improve the human condition, UNESCO, 1985. Thus, technology involves the purposeful application of knowledge, experience, and resources to create processes and products that meet human needs. Education technology is the use of technology in education to improve learning and teaching. Since education technology is often associated with and encompasses instructional theory and learning theory, it is also called instructional technology or learning technology. The term education technology was recognized in the year 1967 with the establishment of the National Council for Educational Technology in the United Kingdom. The United Kingdom Association for Programmed Learning promptly added educational technology to its title in 1968. The main objective of education technology is to modernize the learning methods and techniques after systematizing them so that these may be turned effective according to the needs of the changing era and for the unknown future, making desirable modifications in the behaviors of the teachers and pupils by improving the teaching, learning, and evaluation conditions, and making the classroom teaching easy, clear, interesting, effective, understandable, objective, and scientific is also its objective. The components of education technology include behavior technology, which emphasizes the use of psychological principles in learning and teaching. The instruction technology, which includes materials prepared on the basis of modern machines. And finally, the teaching technology, which makes teaching more effective, easy, precise, and objective by using scientific principles. easy to access course materials, that too for a wider audience, successful long distance learning, availability of various education software, possibility of practical application of theory, easy monitoring and maintenance of work, differentiated instruction, and ability to give instant feedbacks to the learners are some of the important benefits of education technology. The scope of education technology depends upon the context in which it is used. In general, its scope lies in developing of different strategies, teaching learning materials, developing human resources and objectives for education based on individual needs. Hope that you can answer these questions based on the session. 1. What are the benefits of education technology? 2. Define education technology and its objective. 3. How does education technology help the teachers? 4. Explain in detail the scope of education technology. 5. What is technology? 6. Which are the three aspects of education technology? 7. What is instruction technology according to S.M. McMurrin? You can go through the books for reference. Education Technology by N. Venkataya, published by S.B. Nangia APH Publishing Corporation, 2008. Education Technology, Teaching, Learning, Dr. Y.K. Singh, Dr. T.K. Sharma, Dr. Brijesh Upadhyaya, published by S.B. Nangia APH Publishing, 2008. Thank you for watching this program. We'll meet again with another topic. Till then, take care.